Alright. What up, guys? I haven't made a sketchbook video in a while, and I actually wanted to show you guys a more personal sketchbook. And when I mean personal, I mean really gay. I actually completed it about a month ago, or maybe 2 months ago. It's been a while, because I was going to this gay bar, and they had this drawing, like this figure drawing session, and I'm pretty sure like you kind of already get an idea, like the gay bar and figure drawing. Yeah, so there's really some provocative stuff, so you know, just so y'all know, it's in the book. And you know, I just wanted to share it with you guys because, you know, lately I've been really busy and it sucks, and that's actually really kind of depressing me. Not like I'm going through depression or nothing like that, but I've been really I've been kind of sad, to be honest, because I haven't really had that time to myself. It's like my life's been revolving around fucking work. So, you know, just want to show you guys the book.
Viewer discretion is advised.
Alright, so basically I'm going to keep this short and sweet because I only have like 7 minutes of recording time. But this book is actually really old. I bought this probably 5+ years ago, maybe even more than that. And I've never gotten a chance to actually finish it. So this was during when I was like my first year of college, which was my only year. And you're gonna see some really ugly sketches from back in the day, but there are new sketches as well from the class. Well, not the class, it's like a figures. I guess it's a class, I don't fucking know. But these were just some projects for art class that I took for a couple months. And you know, nothing really special, to be honest, but these were a thing, I guess. And then so I was just gonna start off with sketches. So just to give you guys a heads up, like I said, it is a gay bar, you know, so I think visually it's gonna be a little more scandalous. So that's the best way I could describe some of these sketches, because a lot of the times they were, you know, if it's nude sketches, I don't think it's really that deep for, you know, if you're watching somebody's sketchbook and it's a lot of nude. So I don't know, I guess treat it like a nude sketchbook or something. I don't fucking know. But this was during the winter of this year. And I really enjoyed going there because I was just able to get back in a groove of drawing and basically just, you know, doing something other than work and, you know, trying to be social, because I'm really not a super social person. I like to meet friends and be friends with people and be cool like that, but I'm a little bit of an introvert a lot of times, and sometimes I have challenges talking to people and making friends. So, but I'm glad that I went, because like, it's funny because they give out like tickets if you win and you get a free drink or something. So I only won once, and the person liked this sketch, I believe, and I thought it was pretty dynamic and pretty well thought out in terms of details and stuff like that. But it was 20 minutes, and then each of the sketches are a different amount of times. And I think I labeled them most of it, but this was my first week going to it, so you're gonna notice. So this was on February the 12th, and I dated some of them. And these are 2 minute sketches, and this is definitely one of my favorite because it's really dynamic. And it's not that dynamic, but I like the angles and I like the textures and the lines. So that's the thing. And it is a watercolor sketchbook, so I was trying to squeeze in as much paint as possible, and that didn't always turn out to give me the best results, but you know, I like most of these. And this one's okay. I'm not really too fond of it. I kind of like the details with his arms. And this was like in between, like nothing special. And then this was 10 minutes. And then this was 20 minutes. I still like this out of, I think this is probably my most dislike painting in this sketchbook, because I was not feeling it at all, to be honest with you. But hey. And then this is another week. I forgot what date this is, but I don't even know what date. I like lost track like every week, but for the most part I went like every week for at least the first 3-4 weeks, and then after that I kind of just fell off because my job got super busy and that like annoyed the shit out of me. But I tried different, I mean, for the most part I did a lot of watercolors, but I was trying like different types of pens and different types of, you know, like color schemes and shades and different, not necessarily materials because I didn't use a lot, but I just wanted to try different looks to see what I can get, like brush pens, Sharpies, regular pens. This was Sharpies, by the way. And this is what I mean by like scantily scandalous poses. But I'm probably gonna put a star or something right there. I don't fucking know. I'm probably not. I don't give a shit. Don't demonetize. Well, I can't get demonetized. But I don't know. But this one is actually one of my favorite out of this whole sketchbook, because it's just, it's a very peaceful drawing. And it just, I think it's really simple, and it's just the little details, just the little strings that's covering the body, and that's it. I thought that was really simple and calming, and I actually really like this. I'm not gonna lie, I would actually frame this and put it in my house somewhere. And this is another one. I think this is, I have like 2 more weeks that I did this, so. I tried Crayola colored markers, and I definitely got some interesting effects with these. And I don't know, these ones don't really wow me, but I was just like, every week I tried something different for the most part. I didn't try to keep it the same style. I'll try different things just to see like if I would get different results that I would like and shit like that, you know. Been there, said that, done that. The 10 minute ones I really like. This one's one of my favorites too, because it's the colors and then the contrast between the colors was really nice. I like that. This one I like too. This one I like as well. Not my favorite, but I do like it. And my camera's gonna cut off, so I'm gonna pause it for a second. Okay, so I have about a minute left. So this one I really enjoyed because I used a Prismacolored marker. I think it was a black marker or gray. And I just love the shades. They are so nice. Oh my God, they are really good. And I got some really good details of this person that was modeling. The model was really well, like really good at modeling. Some of them weren't, to be honest, you know. I think they just got any model from Instagram that looked good, which was kind of like the theme. It's a gay bar, I guess, you know, gotta look good. But I definitely love the marker. It gave me a different it gave me like a different tone, and just gave me really interesting lines, because it was still a brush pen, and I like the different shades of the lines and stuff like that. So I really, really like that. Like this right here. Oh my God, so nice. And this one is like my ultimate favorite one. I lied about the other one. Okay, so I'm back because my phone fucking sucks right now. Yeah, but like I was saying, this was one of my favorite pieces in this whole sketchbook. And I love it so much. I think there's so much details and just the little shit that's not really on purpose. Just happens, like the shading and then the watercolors, the marks and the just the way it dried and stuff like that. This is definitely one of my favorites as well in the sketchbook. I don't know. I love the way the brush pen it's transparent with the colors as well. I like everything about this. And actually, I did lie because there's one more week that I worked. Not work, but like was at this drawing club ish thing. I don't know, gay bar, whatever. But I did one more after, and then I took a look. I didn't necessarily take a hiatus, but you know, I got really busy at work, and just I didn't have time for myself as usual. So this was definitely the last one, and I was just trying to squeeze in as many. These were what, I think about 5 minutes or 2 minute poses. I'm not sure, but I was just trying to squeeze in as many. drawings as possible because there was no space and I only had 2 pages left to be realistic, so I was just trying to squeeze in as many as I possibly could. And you know, like I said, I was trying different mediums. This time I just did some pen I found from the dollar store, and you know, it bleeded because it's not really waterproof, but you know, it's good to see like what works, what doesn't work, you know, what gives you the effect that you might like. And this is the last page of the book. And I actually like this one as well. I think the contrasts are good and the colors are really nice. Could be better, but I definitely still like it. And for my weeks overall at this drawing, it was actually a drink and draw. Now that I fully remember, it was a drink and draw. You get 2 drinks, you draw these models, and you know, you socialize and meet people. And you know, from what it's worth, I've been really liking it because at least I'm trying to meet people and just be more social. It's a little bit hard for some of us because we're literally stupid when it comes to being social. But thank you guys for watching this video, and I hope that you guys like it. I know I haven't been posting in forever, but I'm gonna try to get back into it and just work on more stuff for myself. I think if you guys feel like you're too busy at work or with school or anything like that, just remember to take time off for yourself and always think about your well-being and your mental health. Those are the most important things I think, you know, are the most important, you know, your well-being and your mind, because without those you'll fucking go crazy. So thank you guys for watching. If you like the video, make sure to give it a thumbs up or whatever, or don't, you know. Thank you guys, see you again later.